Good evening. Great to have you here with us tonight. I'm Joshua Robinson, and the only story we've really all been focusing on today is all the heat that has made its way into the Inland Northwest. We've been talking about it all week, just like Thomas Patrick has, who joins us live outside. Thomas, how's it feeling right now?
You know, it feels a little bit better than it did at 10 o'clock, as it was still 89 last hour. It's dipped to 83, so this feels a bit more comfortable. It's still warm, but it may still be too warm to open the windows tonight. Most people still probably weren't running the air conditioning. That's going to be the way it's going to be all of next week. Today's highs, 98 in Spokane, not quite a record high, but everywhere else in Washington, Deer Park, nearby Deer Park, 100 today, 105 out in Moses Lake. Those were record highs on this Saturday. More to come as well, but there's a lot of danger in where else the heat is going to lie. For example, in our cars, I did a little experiment after I got to work today, took the big thermostat, put that in my car, and the temperature just started to climb so quickly. Went from 80 degrees with the air conditioning on to 120 after 20 minutes and over 140. Maxed out the thermometer after 1 hour of sitting in my car in the direct sunlight. By the way, I have a black car, so the paint itself clocked in at 171 degrees on the infrared thermometer. Certainly sizzling, but very much dangerous stuff. Tomorrow, even hotter yet. 104 is the expected high in Spokane. A lot of triple digit heat, and the worst is yet to come. Early next week, when the heat dome is right on top of our area, that's when temperatures could be hitting all-time record highs. Coming up, I'm going to detail just how hot those record highs are city by city and how long the worst of this heat wave is going to last for the region.